in the 1 o'clock hour. I wasn't kidding that Miya Follick was coming to the station. She's here, and we got Miya Follick at Ryman Auditorium tonight. Welcome to Lightning 100. How's it going?
It's going great. It's such a beautiful day today.
Right?
It's very nice to be in Nashville. Very nice to be in Nashville today. The sun's out.
Yes, we and our weather is kind of crazy. Like one day it's like cold and one day it's hot, and this is just right. So I think the high is 71 degrees. Great day to get to the Ryman. So you probably haven't been inside the Ryman yet for your sound check. That's probably next on the schedule.
That's
right?
Next on the schedule. I've never played there, but Jacob has played there with a different artist, but it'll be my first time at the Ryman.
Well, Jacob, who'd you play there with?
It was Natalie Press.
Oh my gosh, we love Natalie. Yeah. So yeah, Natalie, she's lived here sometimes in Virginia, and huge fans. That's terrific. Well, I mean, it's like for people who live here in Nashville, it is our absolute favorite place to get to see anyone. So it's going to be really cool to get to see Miya Follick out at Ryman Auditorium tonight. Been out on tour with Allie and AJ this spring. How's the tour been going? Has it been fun?
It's been really fun.
Yeah,
nice.
I like that.
We're having a good time.
I saw you spent time in Europe recently. How is that? Is that as much fun as it looks like?
Yeah, we were out there with an artist called Dermot Kennedy. I don't know if you're
familiar. We are. Yeah, he's from Ireland.
Yeah, yeah.
He's an incredible singer.
Incredible voice.
And I imagine, what size venues is Dermot Kennedy playing
in Europe? Big size venues. Big venues. And I think we just did Europe with him, and then he went to the UK afterwards. And I think in the UK he's playing even bigger venues, like 10,000 people. So, he's blowing up. It was really cool to be around. His crew was amazing. Europe is so fun to tour in because, I mean, the bread is amazing.
The bread. For the bread, for sure.
Honestly, even like the bread at the... Like, at the hotels where we stay, which are not the nicest hotels, obviously, and the bread will be, like, better than anything that you could find in, like, an artisanal bakery in the U.S. No offense to the U.S. But it's just interesting, and you're learning new things every day, and there's also cities that I've been to before and you come back to and you get to know them better, and that's, like, fun to go visit your favorite like kebab spot in Berlin, yes. You know? it's fun.
That sounds fun for sure. That sounds pretty awesome. I got to go to Italy one time and I relate to the bread thing. Like the bread, it was just
it's much better.
It was so good. And good. I don't know what it is. You know, my family is from San Francisco. I feel like they have pretty good bread there. The French bread, the sourdough French bread is pretty special there. So been spoiled on the bread. We got Miya Follick here doing the Ryman tonight. MiaFollick.com if you are looking for tickets. I actually haven't looked if it's sold out. I think that as of this morning there were a few tickets.
I think there are a few tickets.
Got it. Well, don't sleep on that. We're going to get an in-studio performance. So we're live here on the radio. We're live on volume.com/lightning100 where you can watch this performance in our tiny studio for free. This might be the smallest studio you've been to on tour.
Nope. No.
Okay, good. All right. I like that.
Not even the smallest studio that I've been to. And like, I've made songs in studios smaller than this.
Great. Good. Well, once you're in here, you know, it starts feeling bigger. So what song do you want to play first?
Let's play Bad Thing first. Cool.
Oh, sweet.
Yeah. Well,
I remember getting to hear this song last summer. I saw you play in Boulder, Colorado. And like I walked away a fan. I'm like, you know, I feel like this is an artist that as people discover Miya Follick, they're going to love what they find. And like I feel like we came back and we put it into rotation. So we've been playing it since then. Of course, playing new single as well. But your music is so great, and this is a great song.
Thank you so much. I truly appreciate you playing the song, and this station is so iconic. So it really is an honor to have it played, and I appreciate it. This will be quite a different rendition than is on the record. It's this is our acoustic version.
All right, well, this will be for our Sunday morning unplugged show. Mm-hmm. We got Miya Follick, Bad Thing, live on Lightning 100.
Wake up, hand upon my forehead. Can't believe this is the way I live even now. Still, somehow, told my mom it was the last time. Told myself maybe it's okay one more time. One more time, I don't wanna call. First thing in the morning, desperate for help to feel norm. Over and over and over again, I keep doing bad, 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 bad. I did a bad thing. I wasn't thinking. I did a bad thing. Caught in empty conversations, fake friends and chemical temptations, turn them down. I need to turn those down. This time I will take it slowly, say no to everything I don't need. Turn it down. Turn it down. For help to feel normal. Over and over and over again, I keep doing bad, 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 bad. I did a bad thing. I wasn't thinking. I did a bad thing. I wasn't thinking. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. I don't ever, ever, ever want to go to sleep. Cause I want more and I want more until I wake up, turn around, and I did a bad thing.
Lightning 100 live here in the volume.com studio. That's Miya Follick. Going to catch Miya tonight at Ryman Auditorium. And that is Bad Thing, which is the first single we started playing from the upcoming record Roach, which is going to be out next month, May 26th. I bet you're excited to put this one out into the world.
I'm really excited.
I feel like you probably have been waiting a while. I know that artists, a lot of times after they finish their records, have to wait a little bit before they get to share the whole thing with everyone.
Yeah. It makes me a more patient person, I guess. But we've been playing these songs live. So I feel like in a certain way, in the internet, I feel like nothing's quite ever as under wraps as it used to be. Like,
that's,
you know,
fair.
If you dig hard enough, you'll find every song somewhere. A live version, at least.
For sure, for sure. Well, I mean, May 26th is you know, next month. So
I know.
We're almost there. We've been blasting Get Out of My House here, getting ready for the show tonight at Ryman. And of course, Miya Follick coming into the volume.com studio, which we're on volume.com. If you want to take a peek in here and see this stripped down acoustic version. So as the show tonight, the band tonight, will be a little more electric inside the Ryman, or how many more?
It's just the two of us.
Really?
We've been doing the Europe tour and the U.S. tour, just me and Jacob. Jacob plays keys and sings as well. And I play guitar, and then we have like a little bit of drum track going as well. But we wanted to keep it stripped and intimate.
Yeah.
But it's definitely a little bit more. It's louder than this setup.
Okay. Yeah.
Though
yeah, that's
we
fair.
Like, I feel like we almost come to prefer the acoustic setup.
I mean,
sometimes we like we love playing the songs this way.
If you could do one song acoustic inside the Ryman,
yeah.
Like
we
that,
do a couple
that
songs
would be
acoustic.
The place
yeah.
to
yeah.
do it because
yeah.
they have their own built-in reverb. You don't have to turn on the reverb inside the Ryman. It's just happening.
Yeah. Yeah. We do a couple songs acoustic in every set. But yeah, it's nice to have like these intimate versions of the songs.
Will this be what it looks like when you continue the tour with the Head and the Heart and Father John Misty?
I think so. And then when we do the headline shows, we'll have a band. But I think just for so many boring reasons, it's, you know, just like...
Yeah,
and,
no, I get, yeah,
you know,
yeah.
we're not supposed to talk about it,
but
it's just
bands are expensive.
Like coming back out on the road after the pandemic, it's been expensive. It's been expensive for everybody, from the smallest bands to the biggest bands. Just things are really expensive right
so
now.
So true, yeah.
So
I was talking to someone that was talking about how it's you know, things like gaff tape. Are way
dude.
More expensive than they used to be.
Dude, yes.
So,
so every piece is more expensive, and I think that, I don't know, Jacob, like, does enough for two people. I feel like he's doing a lot up there. And I also just feel like it's nice to sometimes just like play the songs and not especially when you're opening, you know, you have less space on stage and less time, so our setup is super easy and it can just be about like playing the songs and connecting with people and not about having, you know, 80 inputs on stage that take forever to set up. And I know it's just like, I think it's interesting because people will ask about like why we're playing the songs this way. And the answer is a little bit more, maybe more technical than they want to hear.
Well, I love that version that you just did of that song. So I think that people are going to be in for a treat. Even if it's a little bit louder, it's still going to be the stripped down version inside the Ryman tonight. So it blew me away. You know, I had a band in here the other day and they had come together on Craigslist, but I had never heard of someone putting together a band by making a profile on Tinder.
Mm-hmm.
And apparently that's something that you did a long time ago.
I did that a long time ago. When I was first starting out, I didn't really know anybody in music yet. And I was trying to make a band on Craigslist, which was just really, really...
sketchy?
Just pretty... dark, I guess is a good word for it.
Yeah.
But it just seemed like Tinder was where everyone was. Everyone's trying to fall in love or get laid. So I feel like even musicians are trying to fall in love or get laid. So they're especially musicians. So I was like, I just made a profile that said I'm looking for a band. And then I think it linked to my Instagram or something.
Okay.
And that's how I found the first people that played with me live. My first bass player, Bryant Fox, and put together my first band that way. But since then, I've moved on to more of like scrolling through Instagram or just finding people from shows. Actually, Jacob...
Yeah, how'd you find Jacob?
Jacob was playing with another artist in LA, and I just happened to go to the show because my friend was also playing that show. And when we were looking for a keyboardist for this tour, we were just asking for recommendations from people. But, you know, I think skill and style and personality all kind of have to come together to make the right match. Yeah. And we couldn't remember anything about, like, we didn't know your name or anything about, like, how to find you. So I just kind of texted a few friends that I thought might know who Jacob was. And the first person I texted was like, oh, yeah, Jacob Ungerleiter. And I was like, yeah.
Boom.
That is him.
The rest is history. We got Jacob in here, back in Miya Follick. It's tonight. We are back at Ryman Auditorium. Miya out on tour right now with Ali and AJ. And it's over at MiaFollick.com if you want to get those tickets. And that new record coming May 26th. Do you want to play a song? What do you want to play next?
We're planning on playing Nothing to See.
Okay.
Yeah.
Let's do it. This is Miya Follick live on Lightning 100 and on volume.com/Lightning 100.
I know you've been talking to girls on the internet. She's only 19 and I can't compete. I've been trying to change the way I look so you like what you see. I've been losing weight so I could wear these dose-kill jeans. Why did I do that? Why did I do that? Nothing has changed, I'm just setting in. Said I would never be desperate. Look at me, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Now I'm wearing black, cause you like me like that. Said I would never be desperate. Look at me, there's nothing to see here. There's nothing to see. She heard I was through with you, but my heart still stops when I see a green Subaru. You told me that you loved me, but you mispronounced my name. I never corrected you, cause I didn't wanna push you away. Why did I do that? Do that. Nothing has changed, I'm just sitting in pain. Said I would never be desperate. Look at me, why did I do that? Why did I do that? Now I'm wearing black, cause you like me like that. Said I would never be desperate. Look at me, nothing to see here. There's 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 nothing to see. Do
Lightning 100, Miya Follick live in the volume.com studio. Such a beautiful version of Nothing to See There. And I saw that you retweeted a fan who said that they were at your show and you're playing that song and then someone was mispronouncing your name, shouting out the wrong name.
Yeah, it's funny because the lyric is, you told me that you loved me, but you mispronounced my name. And at the show, there was a person saying, I love you, Maya. And it was quite ironic, I guess.
Yeah, someone said art imitates life. And I was like, I bet that life has inspired art.
Oh, yes. It goes both ways.
For sure. Well, we're so grateful to have you here today at the radio station. That was so nice. And it's going to be a lot of fun tonight.
Thank
to
you
rhyme
so
in.
Much.
Definitely don't miss the show. Miya Follick is here in Nashville at Ryman Auditorium this evening. MiyaFollick.com if you want to find out more. I thought I'd wrap things up by playing the studio version of Get Out of My House.